The Akdeniz will lead the flotilla of three ships from Istanbul, carrying more than 5,000 metric tons of aid to Gaza, including medical supplies and food. The flotilla is organized by a coalition of international and Turkish humanitarian groups. They say it's not just about delivering aid, but challenging what they describe as Israel's blockade on Gaza. They want Israel to allow aid to enter from Egypt.
We hope to break the illegal naval blockade of Gaza that Israel has had on it for decades. We hope to certainly bring food, medicines that are needed by the people of Gaza. It's a small drop in the bucket. We're calling for the border of Rafah to be open, where there's tons of food that's waiting.
It's been 14 years since flotilla organizers last tried to break the blockade. The last time, Israeli commandos intercepted the Mavi Marmara, the vessel leading the flotilla. The raid led to the deaths of 10 people. Activists say they are aware of the dangers they face, but say the risk is worth taking, considering the scale of the humanitarian crisis.
We are conscious that it's not a mission without any danger, but the danger and the horror is part of the horror that we want to denounce.
Everyone taking part is having lessons on how to de-escalate a possible confrontation with Israeli forces. There's been no comment from Israeli officials, but analysts warn the risks are real given the tensions in the region.
But obviously, this is a very, very intense time now in Israel. And also, I would be very careful and hope that the authorities are in both sides are aware of what they need to do to make sure that this will not escalate into violence.
The flotilla is awaiting permission from Turkish authorities to set sail. President Recep Tayyip Erdogan has not mentioned the flotilla publicly, but officials say he discussed humanitarian aid when he met with the Hamas leader Ismail Haniyeh on Saturday. Israel condemned that meeting. The flotilla organizers say they are looking for international protection.
Of course we are worried, but we think that the time is now to act, and then we demand support from the international governments, from everybody who has influence on this matter, to facilitate the supply of humanitarian aid.
It's a voyage analysts warn could be fraught with danger for the activists and for the region. Dorian Jones, VOA News, Istanbul.